we continue our coverage of fencing here at the 2013 Sport Accord World Combat Games. The gold medal on the line in men's foil as Great Britain's Richard Cruz set to take on Race Imboden of the United States of America. John Ramdean alongside fencing aficionado David King. And I have a feeling this one is going to be a good one.
Well, I'm hesitant to set any expectations, but I can tell you we started the day with Andrea Cassara, Alaeldin Abul Qasim, Rav Herzik, James John Fay Ma, Andrea Baldini, Peter Yapish, all the stars were here. They're all gone now. It's down to these two. Race Imboden, world number 10, finished 12th at the World Championships, took out Herzik 15-9, then took apart Abul Qasim, the Olympic silver medalist, 15-6, and then his teammate, Miles Chamley Watson, 15-3. Richard Cruz, you see there, getting ready. World number 17, three-time Olympian. He finished 34th at the World Championships, but today he's knocked out Baldini, 15-12, Alexei Cheremisinov, 15-12, and Artur Akhmatkuzin, 15-10. And the thing about Richard Cruz is that when he shows up to play, he can beat anybody in the room. And we'll see how they get on here, both Imboden and Cruz. When I came in this morning before the round of 16, I saw Cruz, Imboden, and Chamley Watson all sat in the ready room over there. And I said to them, if you boys want a shot at getting on telly, you better get after it today. And all three of them have done just that. We start with a parry there from Imboden. Attacking, missing, Cruz off target on his remise there.
The American seems very light on his feet.
But as he steps in, a beautiful stop hit there from Cruz. We're level at one. Race Imboden, in his spare time, is a model in the USA. And lovely counterattack there from Cruz. He's made good use of that all day today.
An action-packed first period here.
And another fantastic effort from Cruz. Knocking out Imboden and then a flick hit across the front. Imboden, a left-handed fencer. Cruz right-handed. Oh, and again, tying Imboden up. And Cruz has come out without any loss of form. Oh, no. Not that white light again. Had persistent technical issues and the finals pieced all evening. And again, Cruz. Today he's knocked out world number 3, world number 4, and world number 6 in this march to the finals pieced. Oh, and another beautiful stop hit from Cruz.
Cruz definitely hitting his stride here, ahead by 5 points.
product. Off target there. The referee's going to go and have a look at this. I think the question would be whether there was a parry and then a counter parry, but he says no parry. Riposte in Boden, and he has his second point. And another parry from Imboden.
Imboden slowly closing the gap here with just over 30 seconds remaining in period number one. Off target.
And lovely attack from Richard Cruz. Looked like he had hit the pause button there for a bit. But back on form. 22 seconds remaining in this opening period. Gold medal match. And that attack in Boden.
That another point scored.
Another beautiful counterattack from Cruz. Let the clock wind down.
And a deep breath by Cruz as he goes his corner.
Cruz has definitely come to play. And he is there with his teammate James Davis, world number seven, who was knocked out early on today by Erwin Lepichu. But Cruz clearly has his eye on gold. Done a fabulous job, especially with his counterattacks throughout the day. And Imboden knows he's got a fight on his hands.
Action about to resume. Period number two about to get underway. We are here in St. Petersburg, Russia, the Sport Accord World Combat Games. Richard Cruz of Great Britain taking on Race Imboden of the United States of America. Gold medal on the line, men's foil.
Again, Imboden comes in, beats Cruz's blade, and we get that white light up again. Again, this time it was Cruz beating Imboden's blade, but there was no contact that would have caused that white light to come off as off target. Cruz surrenders his weapon. He'll pick a new one.
match resumes. Crew still ahead, 4 points.
Oh, and again, that counteraction from Cruz. Just stopping him, Bowden, in his tracks, and we're back to a 5-point lead.
And Bowden, frustrated, shouted out.
And again. It would appear the mechanics have given up trying to deal with this issue. So we struggle on.
Both men getting frustrated at the technical issues.
Well, here he comes again. Have a look. Maybe they should try some chewing gum or something like that. He's got a little testing kit there. He can check the connection.
Well, we've seen the medical officials around during the different arts have some sort of spray can of freeze. Maybe that'll work.
Well, magic spray is good for a lot of things. And it couldn't do any harm, considering what we've been through today with numerous stops over this issue. Is that a good wiggle there to... Back underway. And again.
You see the obvious signs of frustration being displayed by Richard Cruz, hands on his knees. What do I have to do?
Well, this is not good for either of these athletes. Imboden has a 5-point deficit. Cruz wants to get on with it. And it's very difficult to keep your rhythm going, keep your concentration going when you're constantly being...
Is there a point
interrupted
when they bail on the wireless system?
Well, it looks to me like they're changing the connector box to the wireless connector box. They're on cruise. The actual scoring system itself is in the mask. And then there's essentially a wireless repeater that connects it to the rest of the system. And if it works from here on out, I would politely ask why they didn't change that box a lot earlier, but let's see if we can keep some fencing going here.
A gold medal on the line, men's foil.
And another beautiful, beautiful move from Cruz. Stepping in, blocking him, Bowden out, scoring across the front. Attack off target. Oh, lovely. The confidence in Richard Cruz is making it very difficult for Imboden to get on his game. And he is one of the most talented fencers out there, Race Imboden. It's his attack, but off target.
Imboden has to get something done here.
Just an amazing, powerful attack from Cruz. Imboden winds up in the splits.
Three points away, now 2 points away.
And Imboden says, what do I have to do?
Momentum still on the side of Richard Cruz.
Point given as Imboden is going by. Cruz has one opportunity to score, and that has to be in a single motion. And there it is. Just catches him on the back. And Race Imboden managing only 4 points in this gold medal match.
And that is it. Gold medal won by Richard Cruz of Great Britain. And you talked about how talented he is. Well, we got to see it here in St. Petersburg.
Well, I said that if Richard Cruz comes to play, he can beat anybody in the room. And he is just dismantled world number 10, Race Imboden, who is not a shabby fencer, a pushover by any stretch. He himself beat Abu El Qasim earlier today. But Richard Cruz taking out Baldini, Cheremisinov, Akhmat Kuzin, and Race Imboden to win the gold. It's an inspiring performance by this three-time Olympian. And I'm sure that Race Imboden is happy to go home with the silver. But fantastic, fantastic performance.
Confidence all the way displayed by Richard Cruz. You could feel it.
Well, this is big, a big, big start to the season for Richard Cruz. This is a big confidence boost. And I know this is not a ranking event, but you come in and you face a field that includes Kassara, Abu El Qasim, Djapic, Baldini, Ma, all of these great names, and you can't help but come away from a field like that and a win like this and have anything but a big, big boost.
What is next for Richard Cruz after winning the gold medal here in St. Petersburg?
Well, I'm not going to say he's going to go to Disneyland, but he's now got to get ready for the season to start. And the senior season for 2013-2014 will pick up in earnest in January. There'll be a number of Grand Prix events and a number of World Cup events that will provide the ranking basis for in every one of the weapons that we've seen over the past 3 days. And that will provide their positioning, their seeding for the Zonal Championships and then the World Championships. And all of this will build towards Rio 2016. And there is a sort of continual effort to keep yourself in position so that you don't have to essentially fight off for a place at the Olympics. And this is a great kickoff for the season. confidence-wise, I think, for Richard Cruz.
Well, there you have it. Richard Cruz of Great Britain earning the gold medal in men's foil with an outstanding performance. And the American race in Bowdoin goes back to the U.S. The silver medalist, obviously not happy with his performance, but an outstanding outing from Richard Cruz as he wins the gold medal here in St. Petersburg.